Nadia and Natalie took an aggressive approach on The Amazing Race, and it failed them twice. Now they're looking to take on their biggest adventure yet and go all the way.
And help us bring it home, finally. Third time's a charm for us.
On Amazing Race, we had all the basic needs. You take away all the basic needs, and that's survival.
We'll have sleepless nights, empty bellies.
Survival's gonna be way harder than Amazing Race.
And a catch, not even that.
No, it was going. Our blood is thicker than anybody else's blood out here. I can guarantee you that. Because the longest I think we've ever been apart without seeing each other was like 2 weeks. We need help!
Right here, what are your names?
Natalie and Nadia.
Sisters, clearly.
Twins.
Yeah. Just looking at the other people, who here do you think might already be in a little bit of trouble?
Well, we learned on Amazing Race not to judge books by their covers. So it's just depending on the challenges. There's so many factors. And in this game, when it's so social, I feel like it's anybody's game.
I really like Jeremy, you know, the way he fought today and the way he, his emotions after he had to send his wife to Exile Island showed like real, true, like a good heart, you know? So I would say if I had to choose one person as my designated twinnie, it's Jeremy. Everybody loves a firefighter.
Natalie. Typically, you're with your sister everywhere you go. Tonight, your sister is in trouble.
I know, it's like the last day I've thought about Nadia so much. All of us, I feel like half of our hearts are all standing over there, and it's really, really tough.
Bendy, I can understand if you're lifting a log to bring it over here, but just in the morning, that's only 50 pounds, so you're squatting 50 pounds. You think that's a big deal, bro? It's not a big deal.
Unapu getting your first look at the new Coyopa tribe. Nadia voted out at the first tribal council. Natalie, is this one of the first times you've truly been without your sister?
Yeah, truly, yeah.
What does that feel like?
I told everybody I haven't cried in like 10 years.
Really? Not a tear in a decade?
I never cry.
Is the emotion more for your sister that she's out or for you that you're alone?
It's just really hard. Because, you know, there is people here that have been together, you know, 5 years, 6 years. Me and Nadia have been together for 28 years. It's just really hard.
All right, the game moves on. You good to go?
Yeah. God, why? I literally haven't cried in forever.
Well, then it's pent up. You need to get it out.
But you know the stuff we've been going through? It's like you can just let it all out now, you know? You've probably been fighting it.
I would have said I think there's no other bond besides a mom and a daughter, but man, those twins. Ooh. And it's really pretty touching to see a tough girl cry. Ooh. I want to help her.
Oh, Nadia got voted off. She's probably fine. It's just that we're not together. That's probably the hard part. Now it's just like really good motivation for me to keep my head in the game and just play hard so that I can just at least go as far as I can.
Next matchup, Natalie gonna take on Val.
Yeah, Val.
See this for Nadia, Nat. Let's see it.
Coyopa leads 2-1. Survivor's ready. Go! Natalie comes out hard.
Recover and push her legs out.
Val fighting back now. Now it's Val who has Natalie on her back.
Stay low, Natalie.
Push it back lower.
Val is slowly moving Natalie toward the end.
Go, slow roll. Slow roll.
Natalie is not moving.
Chunk home.
Let's go, Val. Fight.
Push her on, Natalie.
Go, go, go.
Natalie back up. Now she's got Val on the end.
Now, Natalie. Go.
Natalie pushing. Almost got her in.
Battle. Sorry, Gail. Damn, Jeremy's got a tough-ass one. Oh, are you kidding me? Poking me with stuff right when I fall asleep?
We're all working here, so sorry I'm working on your sleeping space. What have you done today, Drew? Tell me one thing you've done. Watch us leave and just hung out the entire day while everybody else was working.
All right, Natalie, I heard you. I got it.
understand how you come out here and you're with total strangers and you don't feel the need to just pull your own weight. Drew is just a waste of space. I guess I don't deal with people that are that self-centered and so oblivious to what's going on.
I was giving Julie the benefit of the doubt.
At least she has her loved ones still here. We don't even have our loved ones here. We should be the ones crying. Well, I don't feel sorry for Julie at all. Julie's just covering his ass and trying to cover hers, knowing that Big John made some racist comments and homophobic comments. And I just want the other tribe to just grow, you know, a pair of balls and just stand up against him. I bet you he wouldn't even give if he voted her ass off.
I know he wouldn't.
John has it for Hunahpu to win it right here. And he does! Hunahpu wins immunity for the third straight time!
Change it up! Change it up.
Hey, Mal.
I'm talking to you.
Don't worry about it.
Calling a racist?
Don't worry about it. Hey, Mal, save it.
That's fortunate.
Yeah, right back at you.
Hey, Nat, we're good, girl.
Classy, Natalie.
He's a song.
Very classy girl. I like it.
Yeah.
Good Way for you. Bring the class,
good
Natalie.
For you.
He talks about W's. He lost against her. He lost against Ajon. And still he's sitting there comfortable.
Let her run her mouth.
So vote against him tonight, guys. Just do it.
Don't even pay attention.
And he's a bad sportsman.
Bad sport.
Could you say something
racist.
Homophobic or racist like in your past? Just vote him out. Get together and vote him out.
If you were a man, I would knock your teeth out.
Oh,
you
my
look like
God.
A man.
You can knock me out, bro. I'm not scared of you, bro. I'm not scared of you.
Just
like
turn
the other
back.
Guys in the tribe. I'm not scared of you.
John.
Just been gone down the hoop yet, and Natalie was already hooting and hollering toward us, but we can't find a way to win right now. So she can throw it in our face. What else can we really do? We can't vote her out.
Not yet.
Hunahpu, getting your first look at the new Coyopa tribe. John voted out the last tribal council.
I was just talking to Drew, and he was like, the girls are trying to get the guys out. I said,
Drew just said that?
Drew did, and I said, that's messed up. I'm telling you, they're so dumb. He told me, you,
he just
Drew,
told you that.
He just told me that. I said, there's no guy-girl thing here.
There's
we
no
have no power.
Thing.
That's
wow.
Straight up what I told him. Drew, he's scared the girls are going to vote out guys, which is stupid. We don't even have the numbers to do that, but he's convinced of this girl-girl alliance. Luckily, the guys are kind of a mess, you know. They're not on the same page, which is good.
In the long run, who's winning immunity challenges?
I know. Drew
it's gonna
or
be
John?
Probably
it's
Drew more than John.
Yeah. Well, maybe we get rid of Drew first.
Yeah, I think you're right. Getting rid of Drew, that would be so sweet if we can pull this off. He's so annoying, but we have to do it now while the guys are all over the place.
I'll tell you one thing, Jeremy got that idol.
Came kind of at camp and what the right thing to do was, you know, I heard Keith.
Natalie, what do you think the tribe needs to do tonight?
I mean, I think this is going to be a really critical vote. At one point today, Drew was accusing me that the girls wanted to get the guys out. I was like, what? I got to talk to this boy again, Alec, and be like, dude, remove yourself from a threesome. Now, at this some point, you have to let go of that. Three amigos is no more, man.
Because you got Reed with you.
Yeah.
I honestly can't believe Drew couldn't handle it with him out of the eight.
Either way, for people like us, which is people with singles, if the couples even have one more over us, they're just going to take out singles one by one.
Baylor's going to Exile Island. You now have to choose somebody from your tribe to join her.
I was going to volunteer.
Interesting. You want Julie. And Natalie's offering to go.
I know Julie has provided. She's fought out here.
I mean, I have, but everybody else has too. So.
I haven't.
All right, Reed. You have one person you want to send and one person who wants to go.
Quite frankly, if Natalie wants to go so badly, I'm not going to stop her. So, Natalie, seat up.
Natalie, come on
Thank
down.
Thank you, Natalie.
No problem.
Thank you, Natalie.
Good job, Reed.
Good job. Good job.
All right, Natalie, Baylor, you will head to Exile Island. You will return in time for the next immunity challenge.
I hope we don't get lost.
Thank you, Natalie.
Bye.
Love you, Bay.
Bye.
Baylor is in very good hands. Natalie said, I'll go to Exile. I know that I have Natalie. I know she's with me. And I think it'll be super beneficial.
All right, let's find this tent.
Where is it?
I don't know.
Me making this move to volunteer to go to Exile, I hope it plays in my favor. Once I merge, this will prove to Missy and Baylor, like, listen, we need to take care of Natalie if she's not taken care of.
There's an idol hidden back at your camp. Buried. Flag. 10 of. It is up to you whether you share this information with anyone else.
Baylor had the immunity idol clue. She straight up showed it to me. I didn't ask her. She just showed it to me.
Something. 10 off, something. Buried from the flag.
Getting information from Bela, I feel like long-term is way more important to me right now than some food reward.
I need you guys to find that idol over there, and me and between me and Jeremy, we need to find the idol at our camp.
Yep.
That would be awesome to have.
And then we could run with it.
Yeah.
Me, Jeremy, and Julie, we're on the chopping block now. Long-term, whatever Bela says, I'm listening to, because Missy, I trust, and so if I can trust Missy, I can trust Bela.